Hey, what's up, Alex here. Remember in my Ultimate Smart Home Guide video, I mentioned that the smart home devices are very region-based. What's available or works well in another country might not be the same depending on where you stay. So in Singapore, there isn't many choices for us here as the market is relatively small. Overall, Xiaomi and Akara ecosystem are considered one of the most common and beginner-friendly, which I'll recommend as well. Every now and then, I'll receive all sorts of questions about it. So I hope with this video, we can answer and clear everything once and for all. I'll first talk about a hub, also known as gateway, because this is like the heart of the entire setup. Thanks to Banggood for sending me this Xiaomi Gateway version 3. It has been around for more than a year, but still the latest one you can get. I will talk about this product first and how it compares with the rest of the hubs I have here. I have the original Xiaomi version 1. For Akara hubs, I have both the version 1 as well. If you refer to the model number indicated at the back, it's the same. But one is the China socket, the other one is 3-pin. If you're not familiar with what the hub is for, let me give you a brief explanation. You have a bunch of Xiaomi Akara smart home devices, but they can't work by itself because these are Zigbee and not Wi-Fi Bluetooth devices. One of the benefits of Zigbee is they generally consume lesser power than a Wi-Fi Bluetooth devices. So it's good for this kind of wireless switches or sensors device since they are running on batteries. I will not go in depth to the comparison of Zigbee versus Wi-Fi versus Bluetooth in this video. You just need to know that they are Zigbee, hence you need the hub. This hub will be the one controlling these devices. It needs to be connected to your Wi-Fi as well so that it can connect to the Xiaomi servers for you to control even when you are not home. This V3 gateway not only supports Zigbee and Wi-Fi, but also Bluetooth devices. With that, you are able to link up with those Xiaomi devices that is running on Bluetooth like their door lock, speakers, humidifier, and some of the lights. This means that when you are out of the Bluetooth range, you are still able to control them thanks to the hub. It has a wider coverage range as compared to the previous version. For example, if I place the old Xiaomi hub in the master bedroom, as you can see from the purple light there, it can't reach the switches that I have at my entrance. But with the V3, it is able to detect. In terms of physical difference, you can see the V3 is more sleek without the night light. It's designed to place on a tabletop. It has a mini USB port, so you have different power options. The trade-off is they remove the night light function, but if your socket requires you to plug in a universal adapter, then it actually don't look very nice sticking out like this. Similar to the Akara hubs lineup, they also remove the LED light feature in their M2 hub, but the previous versions all have it. These hubs has a very loud speaker which you could use it as a doorbell ring or to use as an alarm clock. But the V3 can only do a beeping sound. One very noticeable difference once you added this gateway to your Mi Home app is there are many settings you can set for home security stuff. If this feature is important to you, then you will definitely like this gateway. Few days ago, I asked in my community post what questions you have in regards to the Xiaomi Akara Smart Home. First question is on safety, or rather the safety mark in particular. This doesn't have the safety mark. If you ask me, so which smart switches in the market has the safety mark? I'm not sure. Does this mean that this is not safe to use? Of course it will be safe, else there won't be so many people using their products worldwide. And the company will probably close down if there are some big major safety problems with them. Personally, I don't keep a lookout for that safety mark for any electrical appliance I purchase. Because if you're concerned about the safety mark, then every single appliance, the power adapters, cables, basically anything that have electricity passing through it must have that safety mark then. Else it will be like a double standard if you want it just for smart switches. Next is the most interesting question, which is on integration. Ultimately, you want all your smart home devices to be all consolidated on a single platform. And what are these platforms available in the market is basically Amazon Alexa, Google Home, Apple HomeKit, and I consider Xiaomi in this category as well. They all have a smart display product except Apple and their own AI voice assistants on a speaker. If I'm staying in the US, I will go with Alexa. If I'm staying in China, it will be Xiaomi. And in Singapore, where I'm staying, I will take Google. So companies like Acara, Broadlink, Switchboard, Smart Life, Philips Hue, they make smart home products and will want to have their products integrated to these platforms. For example, this Acara Hub, it can work with all four platforms that I just mentioned. You can use Acara products in Mi Home, but you can't use Xiaomi products in the Acara app. If you want to use Google Voice Assistant with it, you want to have Acara Hub and set it up in their app. Both of these hubs, even the one with the China socket, I'm able to connect to the other's region and have it sync over to Google Home. Because for Mi Home, only some of the products, typically the global launch ones, have integration with Google. An interesting product that Xiaomi just announced last month is this new smart clock. Google Assistant and Chromecast built-in, a smart IoT control hub with music streaming. This will be awesome if you can link your Google Home account inside and control both your Google and Xiaomi ecosystem. Again, Google and Xiaomi are considered competitors in this space, so it's nice to see them working together for such integrations. Okay, last set of questions is on the neutral and non-neutral topic. Singapore HDB by default comes with non-neutral for all the light points. Do you need neutral to work? No, you don't. Will there be light flickering issues for non-neutral switches? When there's flickering, there can be different reasons causing that to happen. Even if you're using traditional switches, these kind of things might happen to you as well. What is the benefit of using neutral switches? To me, only the part that it can relay and extend the Zigbee signal is good. If you're doing your house renovation now, should you add neutral wire for all your points? I can tell you it's going to be a lot of electrician work. You can ask your electrician to quote you a price, then decide whether it's worth doing it. In some countries, depending on where you stay, you will encounter power trip, power outage, whenever there's a thunderstorm or heavy snow. These are things that can affect the lifespan of your switches. Surge protection is important in some countries as well. You know, the power bars that you buy might come with a feature called surge protection. This is to prevent random power spike that could damage the device connecting to it and decreasing their lifespan. In Singapore, we are quite fortunate because our infrastructure, our electric current is generally pretty stable. So I would say really need not worry too much. Alright, that's all from me for this video. Give this video a like if it's useful in some ways. And I hope that I managed to clear some of the questions that has been bothering you. In my next video, there'll be a very cool product that I'm giving away, so stay tuned for that. Lastly, Happy Chinese New Year to all the Chinese that's watching. Bye, and I'll see you next time.